Okay, number 13 has brought to mind another formula that we're going to need to remember. So when you make up, you do your practice, you're going to want to remember that y equals a sine of b x minus c plus d. So this basic setup, and this would work the same thing as if this was cosine. The value, the number in front, a, actually it's the absolute value of a, because it could be negative, which sort of inverts it, but flips it over the x-axis if you have a negative. But the absolute value of a is our amplitude. And remember, that's sort of how high and low it goes. So it's the amplitude is, let's see, if we go up and come down. So it's the amplitude is from the x-axis to the top, or the x-axis, the distance. Okay, so that's our amplitude. Our period is going to be determined by b. Standard period is 2 pi for sine and cosine. So if you take 2 pi divided by b, that's going to give us the period, how that has been adjusted. And period is sort of the how long it takes for a full cycle. So a full cycle is going as one wave. How long does it take for that? And again, the standard is 2 pi all the way around the circle. But as b changes, we can either squish it or stretch it out. The phase shift is going to be determined by c. And the phase shift moves it either left or right. And notice it's got this negative here. So C is, when C is positive, there's this negative here. So that's just a shift to the right. Phase shift. And if C were negative, this would become positive. So that's the shift in phase shift going the other way. Let's see, maybe I got that confused. If it's negative, whatever this is a phase shift, yeah, to the right. If C was negative, that would become positive, and that's actually a phase shift to the left. D, notice we're adding, it's outside the function, so that is a vertical, shift. Vertical shift. So that moves the graph either up or down. Okay, so those are all the things we've got going. We don't have too many here. Here for question 13, we only have the amplitude and the period that are changing. So, but I did want to throw this in that it would be a good idea to have all of those sort of in your notes. So kind of have this somewhere. Just before you take the test, again, do review it so you've got it clear in mind and all these details, especially this negative. And then at the start of the test, take your formula sheet and take a blank area and write this down. Do a brain dump, memory dump maybe. Let's do the amplitude first. So y equals minus 3 cosine of 4 pi x. So a is negative 3, our period is going to be the absolute value of negative 3, which is 3. So, I got to be careful here. Amplitude is 3. The period is going to be 2 pi. Over b is 4 pi, so pi's cancel, 2 over 4 is 1 half, so our period now is 1 half, and that is 13.